باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق.
Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another episode of Ramadan Time. Ramadan is the most sacred month of the year for Muslims. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "When the month of Ramadan starts, the gates of hell are closed and the devils are chained." Subhanallah! Ramadan is full of blessings. We should ask for forgiveness as much as we can. Let's move on to the good deed of the day. The good deed of the day. Revive a sunnah. Saminah. You know that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Verily, whoever revives a tradition, sunnah, from among my traditions which has died after me, then he will have a reward similar to whoever acts upon it without taking anything away from their rewards." So, today we're going to revive a sunnah. Are you excited?
Yeah.
Why don't you revive a sunnah as well? Let's move on to the hadith. An Aisha radiallahu anhu, annaha qalat ma khayyira Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bayna amrayni illa akhadha aysarahuma ma lam yakun ithman fa in kana ithman kana أبعد الناس منه ومن تقم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لنفسه إلا أن تنتهك حرمة الله فينتقم الله بها. Narrated by Aisha radiallahu anhu, whenever Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was given a choice between two matters, he would choose the easier course, as long as it was not sinful to do so. But if it was sinful, he was most strict in avoiding it. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam never took revenge upon anything for his own sake. But when Allah's legal bindings were violated, he would take revenge for Allah's sake. Subhanallah! Let's move on to the lessons of this hadith. Number one, Islam as a religion of ease and tolerance in all matters, unless it is something against Allah's laws. Two, we should always forgive and tolerate each other to achieve harmony and brotherliness among Muslims. Number three, a Muslim who is patient and pardons and tolerates others is greatly rewarded by Allah the Almighty. On to the discussion section. Saminah, I'm going to ask you some questions. What happens to a Muslim who is patient and pardons and tolerates others?
Allah.
No, what happens to a Muslim who's patient and pardons and tolerates others? What happens to them?
Sick.
No, shall I tell you? They are rewarded by Allah the Almighty. Hey. Number two, what should we do when our brother or sister... Almighty means when Allah is the best. Okay? Number two, what should we do when our brother or sister takes the toy we are playing with? What do you do when your brother or sister takes away the toy that you're playing with?
You say, "Can I have that, please?"
Yes, you would tolerate them and say, "Can I have that, please?" Number three, how can we show patience and tolerance with our friends at school?
We be kind.
And?
Happy.
Yeah, we would be patient as well, okay? Yeah. Do you know that the Arabic word for patience is sabr? Now that we finished the hadith, let's move on to...
Surah learning.
Yes. Now that we finished the hadith, let's move on to
Surah learning time.
Let me teach you Surah Al-Nasr, because mashallah you have learned Surah Al-Masad, okay?
This is La, this is me.
Okay, repeat after me, okay?
Okay.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
A'udhu billahi بالله من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح
إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح
ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا ورأيت الناس
ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا
فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر فسبح
فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر
إنه كان توابا
إنه كان توابا
Okay, now listen to me again, okay? Repeat after me as well, okay? إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح
إذا جاء نصر الله والفتح
ورأيت الناس
ورأيت الناس يدخلون لله أفواجا
فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر
فسبح بحمد ربك واستغفر
إنه كان توابا
إنه كان توابا
ما شاء الله I put it in bits for you but you said the whole thing Well done If you teach your brother or sister at home...
Even your little sister, your brother.
Yeah. If you teach your grandson, son, granddaughter, daughter, whoever it is that you want to teach...
Even your kids.
Yes. Whoever you want to teach, you don't have to teach them in big chunks. You can put it up into pieces.
If you're sure you can't learn it, if you're just like you are... You can learn it by yourself.
But if you can't, you can put it into small chunks for you to learn it.
Yeah, to make you like, to make you learn it.
Okay, it's time for us to end the video. Inshallah, we'll see you tomorrow.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq.